doctors. Probably about 6 weeks ago, Swanwick Gospel Choir sang with G4 in concert at Victoria Hall in Hamley. They were doing a UK tour and we got selected to sing with them. So we were like their backing choir, which was very exciting. We had a fantastic night. And this has never been done before, like quite literally actually. But we're going to sing Barcelona, which is one of the songs that we sang with G4. What is really exciting is that we've got two guest soloists who also have never sang before at all. It's a very difficult song, this, and Steph and Johnny have learned this, especially for this evening. They've never sang it out before. Not to put any pressure on you guys, and Johnny spent probably about 4 hours in the car. This happened. Has anybody got a tissue? I'm sorry, I can't see. I'm not crying, I'm just making sure if you're you literally got here at 10 past 7, was it? 20 past 7. And we literally ran through it, and that is it. So you guys deserve a medal because they're really committed. And it's hard work being in a car with a crying baby. It's a bit stressful. So just can you give a special thank you and a clap, please? This is Barcelona, and then after that we're going to sing a totally contrasting song called Cleanse My Heart. Sorry, you can.
Thank you. I believe the writer of that is a guy called Fred Parson. And actually he was good enough, Fred, to give that music to the Salvation Army. So it's a lovely link for me, because I was one of the guys that helped proofread and edit that song into one of our journals. So it's really nice to hear his song, because we use just office work sometimes. So it's lovely to hear it come to life, especially outside of the Salvation Army. So thank you. Really lovely to hear that. And a great thing for all of us. Do you know, even those of us that are Christians, we need that new start each day, don't we? We haven't got life sewn up. Don't anyone be in any doubt here that it's not a Christian, that all the Christians have got it all right. That is not the case. We need our heart cleansed each and every day, don't we, friends? All of us. So thank you for that lovely reminder. Now, in the Salvation Army, we're very good at changing moods. And we're about to do that. Is that okay? If we lighten the mood again. Right, now would you mind, this sounds very, it's a bit much, I know, but would you mind just clapping for a moment? Is that alright? Would you clap? So, now could you, and the band are going to help you, clap just the once. Ready? Go. Let's get it together. Ready? Here we go. And. Beautiful. And again. Right. Now, can you all clap once? And twice? And three times? So, here, let's have this group. You do the one. And this guy's in the middle here, you do two. And then everyone over here, three. Here we go. So, we are now going to learn some music all together, is that alright? Here we go. The band have got something specially they prepared. Here we go. Are you ready? You know me well now, don't you? Right, here we go. One, two, two, two.
Thank you. Hello. Dean's asked me to share a scripture thought with all of you this evening. Suddenly dawned on me halfway through that piece. I think the reason he chose me is I'm the oldest one in the band tonight. There might be one or two other contenders, but I'm fairly close to the oldest. Anyway, there you go. That's what happens when you get old and get asked to do the serious stuff. So what can we talk about? There's so much happening in 2016, isn't there? So can we talk about Brexit? Should we stay in the European Union or should we leave? Do you want to talk about that tonight? What about Euro 2016? Hopefully France are losing as we speak. No, they're not, sadly. Someone's watching over there. Okay, we can talk about the US presidential race. Trump or Clinton? I'm not sure either of those is really a great option for us, is it? What about the Queen? Yeah. Not Johnny singing, but the Queen's life in America. We can talk about that, can't we? Olympics? Well, Olympics this year, we can talk about those. What about celebrity deaths? There's been loads of those, haven't there? There's got to be something we can talk about. Prince? David Bowie, Muhammad Ali, Victoria Wood, Paul Daniels maybe? No. Well, there's lots of different things that might have impacted our lives this year. For me, the biggest impact on my life has been the death of a less well-known person. And that was a young Salvationist called Amy Askew. Amy's from the Salvation Army in Longford. I used to attend the corps at Longford a long time ago now. Last time I saw Amy, she would have been about five. I knew her parents very well. Sadly, this year, I think Amy, now aged about 25, Amy died, or she was promoted to glory, as we like to say in the Salvation Army. She suffered a terrible accident in Australia and was in a coma for an extended period of time. Now, all over the world, aided by social media, there was a massive outpouring of prayer for her and her family. It hasn't stopped. I know the funeral was yesterday. And people continued to pray for that family. And it was just amazing the way that people sort of came together and joined in that prayer room. But I'm sure I'm not alone, and I felt totally devastated when sadly Amy died. I just felt that my prayers had no impact on that situation at all, that my prayers were wasted, that I hadn't been answered. Maybe it was because I hadn't prayed hard enough or for long enough, or I had a lack of faith and there was something wrong with what I was doing. And I kept thinking, something's wrong here. You know, this situation has really troubled me. It's been a few weeks since she died, and it's been preying on my mind and really affecting how I've been thinking about things recently. Now, I'm lucky. I go to Oaken Gate Salvation Army. Oaken Gate Salvation Army is fantastic. So if you're ever in Telford, come along to Oaken Gate Salvation Army. I have to say that because my ministers are back over there. This Sunday, I had a really strange experience at church. The service, and particularly the message from our minister Julian, felt like it was aimed just at me. It seemed like he knew exactly what was on my mind and he was talking directly to me. So we opened the service with words from Psalm 91. He is my refuge and my stronghold, my God in whom I trust. And then later on in the service, Julian used a quote from Reverend John Stott, who says, "Prayer is not a convenient device for imposing our will upon God or bending his will upon ours, but the prescribed way of subordinating our will to his." Okay, so it's not a way for us to get our will from God. It's about us understanding his will and fitting in with his will. And it just kind of struck me when he spoke about that, there is so much more out there, and so much more that God knows about this situation, and I can only see a small part of that. So this healing was not, the lack of healing wasn't a failure on the prayer on my part, or on all those other people that were praying. It's not like prayer is a slot machine where you can just walk up and pop coins in, and when you get to the right number, the right thing pops out the bottom. God has a purpose in all of this. And I realised then that in respect to Amy, my prayers and a thousand of others have not been wasted or ignored. The lack of the visible answer to prayer was not down to my lack of faith or lack of effort on my part. I realised that I'd fallen into the trap of confusing my will and God's will, and I didn't trust God. I wonder if this is an area that other people might also struggle with. The Christian writer C.S. Lewis writes of prayer, "For prayer is request. The essence of request, as distinct from compulsion, is that it may or may not be granted. God does not always respond to our desires, but frequently allows circumstances we wish he would not." Theologically, I'm told this is called sovereignty. Inherent in our faith is the idea that God is always in control. The picture we see of the world in which we live and the specific situations we pray for are not necessarily the picture that God sees and that he knows much more about. We do not, and we cannot know everything. Instead of letting circumstances consume us and overwhelm us, we should be consumed by God. To that end, we should pray without ceasing, trust in his sovereignty, and find comfort in his hope. The piece that the band just played includes the following words: "When the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you are God. Find rest, my soul, in Christ alone. Know his power in quietness and trust." Amen.
The Lord our God, who lives among us, who is mighty to save us, who delights over us in perfect love, rejoices over us with joyful songs. As the psalmist said, the Lord delights in those who fear him, but their hope leans on the hand of God. He graces our days with his hands, gladness, and blessings for us, with nocturnes of peace and tranquility. His orchards of love form the soundtrack of our lives. He is the wellspring of all our need, and we offer him a new song, our very own song of joyful gratitude. Our majestic God is the master orchestrator of creation, to whom all of heaven and earth perform their symphony of praise. And in the name of Jesus, people of every nation and every tongue will bow down and sing, "Praise and power, honor and strength be to our God, forever and ever."
Thank you. close. And I want to say to you here this evening, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your friend and saviour, please come and talk to either some of us in silly white shirts or any of these guys here. I'm sure they will be willing to talk to you. And we're going to sing a song that says, King of Kings, Majesty. And the chorus says, Your Majesty, I can but bow. I lay my all before you now. In royal robes, I don't deserve. I live to serve your Majesty. So let's stand and sing this song together. The beautiful worship song, King of Kings, Majesty.
agreed. You have a great time in Derby tomorrow and on Sunday. And those of you who are travelling back tonight, please drive safe. And I know you'll be joined by others in the group tomorrow as well. So, my gospel choir, you did fantastic. Thank you very much.